Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode. So again in this class I will be dealing with the four editorials of today's The Hindu editorial page. Now first of all we have this lead editorial, and then we have the sub lead editorial, and then we have the left corner editorial, left top corner, then we have the bottom corner editorial. Now when it comes to the lead editorial, it is about OBOR, One Belt One Road initiative of China. So we have already dealt this in the previous classes, so in this class we will not be focusing more on this editorial, though we will be understanding India's stand, why India don't want to be party to China's initiative of One Belt One Road initiative. Now one, when it comes to the lanes of communication in the modern era, these lanes of communication, they have really gained a lot of importance, because if you have the power to control these lanes of communication, you actually have the power to control of how the world economy actually works. Agar aap lanes of communication ko bahut acche se control kar pa rahe ho, to aap duniya ki jo economic diplomacy hai usko control kar pa rahe ho. And when you are able to control the economic diplomacy of the world, this is something that you can really unleash in the world. And what is this? This is neo colonialism. Now this is something that what China is actually doing. So this was one of the fear of India, that why India has not joined this project of OBOR. This is the first reason that India was actually fearful of. And the second reason why India has actually not joined this project is because it is passing through Gilgit-Baltistan region, and this Gilgit-Baltistan region is a kind of a disputed territory between India and Pakistan. Now because it is passing through this disputed territory, agar India isme participate kar jata to indirectly jo Pakistan ne iske upar kabza kiya hota hai usko hum jaiz maan lete, we would have accorded legitimacy to the occupation of Pakistan about this region of Gilgit-Baltistan. So this is the second concern of why India don't want to be party to this. And thirdly, India is actually fearful of China's economic diplomacy. Economic diplomacy. And fourthly, as per India's official stand, this OBOR project, it is actually mired in controversy with respect to that China is not very transparent. China is not very open about this entire project. So it is not addressing, it is not assuaging the concerns of India. Jo bhi India's ke concern hai about this project, those concerns are not being addressed by China. So lack of transparency is another issue. Lack of transparency. So there is a transparency issue, economic diplomacy issue, and there is an issue of neo-colonialism, and there is an issue of Gilgit-Baltistan. Now in the, if in the mains you get a question on this, you must mention these four reasons properly. They must be mentioned in the form of points. Don't try to write answers in the form of paragraphs if the question relates to the specific stance of why India is not joined. So you must put forward the reasons in the form of points. Now the second editorial of the day is about the sub lead. Now what is this sub lead editorial? Now this editorial relates to the Tamil rights. Tamil, now this is very important. Tamil rights of Sri Lanka. We need to understand this Tamilian affinity to Indians. Abhi Tamil population ke jo rights hai Sri Lanka mein, India usko leke itna zyada concerned kyun hai? In order to understand this, we need to know about the history of connectivity, history of relationship between Tamil Nadu and Sri Lanka. Now 200 years back, the Tamilians, they have actually migrated to Sri Lanka. So they have a kind of connectivity with India. They treat India as the motherland. And Indians also feel a lot of affinity to these Tamils because they are nothing but the children of India. So India is really concerned about the Tamil rights. Now what is this entire issue about Tamil rights? Now in order to understand this, we need to understand the history of Sri Lanka. Now agar Sri Lanka ka map dekhte ho, broadly it is like this. And north and northeast of Sri Lanka, this is the region in which you will find the maximum concentration of the Tamilian population and also the Muslim population. Now the Tamilians, they have a grievance. They feel disenchanted by the kind of treatment that is meted to them. Jo bhi unka garibi ka halat hai, jo bhi poverty hai, jo bhi unko welfare measures nahi milte hain, to un cheezon ka sara jo kasoorwar hai wo Sri Lanka, Sri Lankan government ko thehrate hain. Now the Tamilian population is actually the minority in Sri Lanka, and this is the reason why they feel discriminated by the government. Now the Tamilians, they want that they should have more kind of provincial autonomy. So this was, and this is their demand since the insurgency of the Tamilians started in Sri Lanka. Jo ugravad hai wahan pe Sri Lanka mein, jo terrorism hai jo Tamilians ne wahan pe kiya hai, it has started because of the discrimination by the majority population of Sri Lanka. So their main demand is that as per the 13th constitutional amendment, they should be provided more of the provincial autonomy. Inko zyada provincial autonomy di jaye. So ye main demand hai. This is also the demand of India. India also wants that in the new constitution that the Sri Lanka will be coming out with, they should actually be addressing the concerns of the Tamilian population. And recently, Narendra Modi has visited the area in the north of the Sri Lanka, which includes the Tamilian population. And a lot many people, bahut log jo Tamil ki Tamilians hai, wo Narendra Modi ko sunne aaye wahan pe unka bhashan. Kyun sunne aaye? Because they feel affinity with India. Now, the top left corner editorial. Now this editorial deals with the debt issue of the states in India. Abhi states ka jo karza hai usko leke ye editorial hai. Now when it comes to the Indian states, they actually don't have lot of financial resources. They are actually dependent upon states. Now India mein jo federal system hai, it is actually pseudo federal. We don't have the proper federal system in India. We have the pseudo federal system. Now why I'm calling it pseudo federal? It is pseudo federal because the states in India, they are not completely powered. They are actually dependent upon the central government. So this was one of the grievances of the states. So states hamesha kehti thi ki unko paisa center se lena padta hai. But agar hum finance commissions ki reports ko padhte hain, to finance commissions ne kafi recommendations state ke paksh mein diye hain. And recently the 14th finance commission has recommended about increasing the share of the state governments to the level of 42% from the 30%. 30% se bada ke isko 42% kar diya jaye. So despite states ka jo share hai 42% ho gaya, still the fiscal deficit of the state is really increasing. High, it is touching about the level of 3%. And this editorial ye ek concern hai ki states apna kharcha kaise kam kare. Dekhiye, states ke upar bahut zyada kharcha aa raha hai. Pehla kuch schemes like Uday, Ujjwal Discom Assurance Yojana. Now electricity sector ko reform karne ke liye ye wala scheme hai. And secondly, jo bhi centrally sponsored scheme thi, centrally sponsored schemes thi, wo abhi kam ho gayi, decline ho gayi hai. And states, they really need to increase their expenditure with respect to the social sphere and the social domain. And that is only possible by crossing the limit of the fiscal prudence. And thirdly, स्टेट्स के पास खुद के फिस्कल रिसोर्सेज बहुत ज़्यादा कम है. स्टेट रियली नीड्स टू वर्क ऑन दिस फिस्कल रिसोर्सेज. स्टेट ये फिस्कल रिसोर्सेज कहाँ से पैदा करे? फॉर दैट वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड द रिकमेंडेशंस ऑफ द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ अर्बन डेवलपमेंट. मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ अर्बन डेवलपमेंट क्या कहता है स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स को? कहता है कि आप म्यूनसिपैलिटीज और पंचायत्स को एम्पावर कीजिए ताकि वो प्रॉपर्टी टैक्स लगाएं. बट बिकॉज ऑफ द मेजर्स ऑफ पॉपुलिज्म, अभी जो हमारी सिटीज हैं वहाँ के जो वहाँ की पॉलिटिक्स है वो स्टेट गवर्नमेंट को अलाउ नहीं करती है कि वो टैक्सेस ज़्यादा म्यूनसिपैलिटीज़ के ऊपर इम्पोज करे. अगर म्यूनसिपैलिटीज़ के ऊपर ज़्यादा टैक्सेस इम्पोज करते हैं लाइक इन द फॉर्म ऑफ गार्बेज टैक्स और इन द फॉर्म ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी टैक्स, सच काइंड ऑफ टैक्सेस दे डोंट यील्ड द प्रॉपर रिजल्ट. सो दिस इज द रीजन व्हाई द स्टेट्स दे आर नॉट एबल टू फॉलो द पाथ ऑफ द फिस्कल प्रूडेंस. बट for the proper health of the economy of the state, it is very, very important that they should be resorting to this fiscal prudence. Abhi recently, government had set up a committee, and as per that committee, rather than following this fiscal path, that the, how much should be the fiscal deficit, the government should actually fix the ratio of what should be the debt to the GDP ratio. And in that, the 20%, the debt to the GDP ratio of the state should not increase this limit of 20%. And in order to read more on this, you can just read the booklet of Brainika that we will be releasing soon for this month. So that booklet will be covering all these editorials, all the important current affairs in the form of the points. Like they, we have designed a very good structure. There's a structure in the form of, first of all, there will be introduction of the topic. Then there will be background of the topic, then the important things and the concepts that relate to a particular topic will be discussed in that. So this is about the lead editorial, the sub lead editorial and this editorial. Now when it comes to the bottom corner, I will not be discussing it because this is not very important from examination point of view. Yesterday also I have discussed about this because this was part of the sub lead editorial, that is the election of the Hassan Rouhani and Mr. Raisi. Now Hassan Rouhani, he is actually a liberal leader in Iran. Now when it comes, when we understand, agar hum sare Iran ki politics ko understand karte hain, to Iran ka ek revolution aaya tha, 1979 revolution. To wo jo revolution tha, usne Iran ko fundamentalist bana diya tha. It had put Iran on the path of fundamentalism. So jo ye jo Hassan Rouhani hai, ye us path se Iran ko remove karne ki koshish kar raha hai. So we also had the previous president Mohammad Ahmadinejad. Now Mohammad Ahmadinejad was again a very conservative leader. He wanted to put Iran on the path of fundamentalism and theocracy, and they don't want Iran to integrate with the western forces or with the liberal forces. Now Raisi jo hai wo in forces ko represent karte hain. Now all these editorials that I have discussed with you, you should not be remaining confined to jo maine bataya hai. You should actually try to explore more on these editorials. Like you should be reading about fiscal responsibility and budget management act. You should be reading about how states really need to improve and work upon this fiscal prudence path. And you should also be reading about the history of the Tamilians in Sri Lanka. And you should also be reading about OBOR project and relevancy for India. And you should also be reading about what should be the India's response to the challenges put forward by China, how India can respond to these challenges, because China bahut zyada challenges pose kar raha hai India ko. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.